far today. There's a huge school right out here, right past my mouth. And I only know that because they keep coming up to the surface to grab some air. So that's how I identify where they are. I'm using quite a simple rig today. It's literally just braided line all the way attached to a little float and then a hook right here in my fingers. This is a size 4 hook. You have to use small hooks because they have narrow jaws. Anything bigger, they'll feel it and drop it. So that's the rig. This is actually a lot shorter than I usually do it, but today, this is the only time, the only way I've been getting bites so far is to have a really short distance between the bobber and the hook, because they're right up on the surface out here. What we're using for bait is actually a little bit of a variation of cut perch and cut bluegill. This is a perch chunk right here, and I cut them to the size of the gar that I'm after, so a chunk this big will probably catch a gar at least 36 inches, so they won't get the smaller ones. That's the hope. Usually, that's what happens. So what I do is I take the hook and I go through the meat, through the bones, and just gently poke it up out where the spines usually are. Now I cut the spines off just to try to minimize, you know, any issues the gar might have to chewing it down. So that's the rig. I'm going to throw it out, and when I wait for this bobber to go down, once the bobber starts going down or moving, or whatever it does, I give it about 30 to 60 seconds, depending on how hard it's fishing. And that just gives the gar time to get the bait down. You set the hook too early, and the bait is still in the actual long jaws of the gar. You're going to have a very hard time hooking them because they're so bony. Much easier to wait until they got through closer to the corner of the mouth or down to the soft part of the throat, and that's where you can hook them. So I got my bobber out there. I don't think you guys can see that because of the waves. It's a small bobber, but it's out there. I'm just going to wait for it to start doing something. Until that happens, I leave the bell open like this. That way, in case a gar grabs it and starts running with it, one, I don't lose a pull, and two, if the gar's not ready yet and they feel tension, they'll actually drop that bait. So even when that bobber does start doing something and going down, I'm going to be feeding line off the lip of the gar to try to make sure they don't feel any tension. Once I'm ready to set the hook, however, I'm going to shut it. Kind of make sure I'm going to drag real tight. That way, you get a nice hard hook set. And that's part of the beauty of using braid strictly rough. You get a nice, nice hard hook set. Use mono, has too much stretch. You're going to probably have a really hard time hooking these things. Alright.
Guard.
not small, but he ain't the monster. I'm done admiring this guy. I'm gonna get him back in the water. He's 37 inches, so he's a couple inches smaller than the one I got this morning, but he's still a nice fish, still fought good. Like I said, use the bigger baits, so pretty much can only catch a 36 inch and a half. I'm not sure if he's actually hooked or if he's just wrapped up in the line. I think he's wrapped up in the line, to be honest. But that is a 40 inch plus gar. If he's actually not fighting me, he's hooked. Thank you. barely hold him up. Holy shit. Virginia citation gar right there. Oh boy. Take a look at those teeth.